Hello, my name is Sophie Walker. I'm here today at Prestbury Golf Club with Golfalot.com to review the new TaylorMade SIM irons, the SIM Max and the SIM Max OS. I can't wait to give these a go. We're here at the fabulous Prestbury Golf Course to do some outdoor testing. Now we've got the 4-iron, the 6 and the 8-iron. We're going to hit some tee shots, some fairway shots, shots out of the rough to get the playability of these clubs outside. Then we're going to head inside to the range to get the numbers and the stats. First impressions. You can see the sole is a bit bigger on the OS, which you would expect because it's the more performance enhancing iron. When you set the clubs down, the top edge is about the same width, which is ideal for me because I don't want to look down on something really chunky. The OS is more offset, which is to be expected, and you can just see the bulk at the back of the club, but that's me being quite picky. Can't wait to have a go of these. So manufacturers used to say you can either have the forged feel of an iron or the performance enhancing iron. You couldn't have both. TaylorMade are saying that now you can. So this is a performance enhancing club with a forged feel and sound. So I'm going to have a go with the Max first. 6-iron, fourth hole at Prestbury. It's 160 yards, but it's downhill. Flew nicely, didn't have that tingy noise that you would expect with a performance enhancing club. Felt solid through the strike, which could be to do with all this speed bridge. Went about where expected as well. Now we're going to go on to the Max OS. Now this is TaylorMade's most performance enhancing club of 2020, but how will it feel? Now I thought that sounded different, but I tell you what, it did fly further. I like that. Don't think the noise was too out there. It felt less like a performance enhancing club off the face. It definitely sounded different to most performance enhancing clubs. Could be onto something. We're here on the green. Now this was the Max shot. Didn't quite get it possibly. Good shape, exactly the same shape as the OS, but the OS really did travel. It might have made a slightly different noise, but you're definitely getting the distance. I mean, there's about 8 yards difference between these two. Granted, I struck this one well, but was that to do with the technology in the head? Let's try a few more shots and see. I found the rough off the tee. I've got the Max iron here, and I'm gonna try the Max OS as well. It's an 8-iron. 130 yards playing. I want to see how this performs out of wet, not too thick rough. Will this speed bridge help the club stability? It came out well, it came out high. It's a nice shallow divot, that performed very well. Now for the OS. Exactly the same shot, distance, lie, but this time with the Max OS. Travelled a bit further, did catch it thin. I didn't feel the strike was as good, but it went the distance. It's like the rough wasn't even there. So these irons are packed with technology, but what's new about the SIM? It's got a 17% thinner face, which is going to increase ball speed. It also has an echo dampening system inside the head, which is going to enhance the sound and the feel of these golf clubs. So what TaylorMade have done is they've added to the already successful M5 and M6 technology. They've got the inverted cone technology, the speed slot, and the speed bridge. So what I like is they're just adding to it. They're not taking anything away, they're trying to make it better. Now, I'm gonna hit a 4-iron here. Downhill lie, 170 yards. Let's see how well they perform. We'll go with the Max first. Came off really well. Nice low ball flight, but that could have been due to the lie. But the sound felt pretty good, didn't it? Now on to the Max OS. Now this club should be perfect for this shot. Because it's a downhill lie, I'm gonna need the launch off these irons to help the ball get in the air. Significantly higher ball flight than the last iron. It's a great club for this shot. I've come in from the cold, inside, to get the numbers on these golf clubs. So outside, I felt like the OS did perform better in terms of length. And between the two, there was definitely a different sound. I'm gonna come in here and compare these with 8-irons, 6-irons, and also I'm gonna put the M5 in there to compare against the Max. So the M5, for me, should have a different noise and a different feel, and hopefully the SIM Max will be something which makes me feel like I'm hitting a forge, but it'll perform like a performance enhancing iron. Looking down at this golf club, the top edge isn't as thick as what you'd expect. I think that's what TaylorMade have done well, especially with the OS. The Max and the OS are very similar top edge. Got the green set at 150 yards. That's about what I'm gonna be hitting my 6-iron today. When I say today, I mean that's like my average. I'm not gonna step on it. I'm not gonna back off it. This is just my usual swings. The TaylorMade are going big on ball speed. Their face is 17% thinner. So the thinner the face, the higher the ball speed will be. I think with this iron, it's very much on the limit of better golfers, okay? So if you're somebody that plays off single figures, but if their worst part of their game is iron play, which that's my worst part of my game, and obviously I'm a professional, these might be something that you can put in the bag. If you are a true iron player and love to look down on a very thin top edge, then these might not be for you. However, for a, you know, performance enhancing iron, that top edge is not bad at all. So I think anybody kind of over category one and higher could definitely have a look at playing these irons for sure. Little fade. Workability, absolutely fine. Not noticing that they perform any worse than my forged irons. Moving on to the Max OS. Now this is oversized, so everything's a bit bigger. It's slightly more offset. This is the ultimate game improvement iron that TaylorMade are producing for 2020. It's higher launching, maximized distance. I'm expecting this one to go a touch further. Can definitely see the bulk at the back of the club more on this iron, but it's not horrendous. Let's try another draw. I bet I can get a lot more out of this one now. A big draw. Look how far I can get that one club to go. 164 yards, 6-iron. And looking down on it, I don't like to see an offset because I'm not used to it. But if people are buying these type of irons, they're well used to seeing an offset. So that's not gonna put those type of people off. Right, let's go for that big draw again. Now with a game improvement iron, I always want to see how far can I hit it? What is the maximum distance I can hit this 6-iron? Yeah, 164 yards, so it's not scary, which is quite refreshing to see. Now, I'm going to play last year's M5. Take notice of the difference in the noise. That's what we really want to hear, which you guys can hear, and I'll try and translate the feel to you as well. Let's have a go. Oof, that sounded like a crack. That's not something that I've ever been used to, so I'm starting to understand what all this noise and feel is about. Let's have another go. I think inside it really highlights it, but the difference in the noises are quite clear to hear. So my verdict's on the TaylorMade Max irons. I didn't notice a great deal of difference in the ball speed. They were all much of a muchness, especially compared to last year's model. Very similar. So the thinner face didn't make any difference with my testing. What I would say is out on the golf course, I felt the OS, well, it did go further, noticeably 6 or 7 yards further than the Max. In here, not so much, but it was very noticeable on the golf course. I've never noticed the difference in noise and feel between golf clubs. And now I think, of course I haven't, because I never used performance enhancing golf clubs. So now I understand, okay? So what TaylorMade have done is try to make a club which feels like a forge, but still has distance. And I actually think they really have done in this case. There was a significant difference in the noise and the feel compared to last year's model. Now, talking about last year's model, the M5, okay? Now that's kind of disappeared now because the P790 has been so successful in terms of the range of golfer it appeals to. So that's gone. These now come in with the 899 price, which is like the M6. Okay, so these are replacing the M6, but the noise is being replaced also, which is the key. Now, who I would recommend these to? Definitely the OS, okay? The Max is just a good golf club, okay? I think you could play the P790 or the Max, depending on how you feel. But the OS is something which I think high handicappers could really game. And you're not only improving your distance and your launch, you're not sounding out the entire golf course with that awful tingy noise. You're sounding like your mates that play a 5 or 6 handicap, and that can only be great for your game and the way you feel about it. That was my review of the TaylorMade SIM iron range. If you've enjoyed this video, please click the subscribe button below. Check out my written review on golfalot.com. See you next time.